Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats and direct your attention to the video screens for a special message from the graduating class of 2012.
Welcome parents, grandparents, family, and friends to the 2012 graduation ceremony for Ayden-Grifton High School.
We are happy to see you all here and excited to get started.
But before we do, we have a few requests because we want to make this day as special as possible.
First, please take this time to turn off all cell phones.
Second, movement can be distracting, so we ask that you remain seated throughout the ceremony and wait to leave until all of the graduates have left the arena.
Finally, we know that you all want to cheer us on. Please refrain from shouting, cheering, and using noisemakers. We all want to hear our names called.
We appreciate your compliance because today is a special day.
Today is the day we celebrate our achievements,
our efforts, and success.
This is my day.
This is your day.
This is our day.
Thank you for your support. Let's start celebrating.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the national anthem and the Pledge of Allegiance. Gentlemen, please remove your caps. Join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated.
Welcome to the graduation of the Ayden-Grifton Class of 2012. It has been a tough, fun, crazy journey through the last 4 years, but we have finally made it. From insane classes, those crowded halls, and even a tuberculosis outbreak, we've managed to make it here today. The fact that you're sitting here in your cap and gown means that you have achieved something great. It means that you have put forth a tremendous amount of time and effort and achieved something great. Never forget that this is something that you have earned. The school isn't just handing out diplomas to everyone. It takes a certain kind of person to make it this far, so be proud. Now for many of us, today may be the last time we see all of us here together. But this isn't a bad thing. We're all simply going off in different directions and chasing different goals and or dreams. But one thing we will always have together is the memory of our graduation and where we came from. Because whether or not we're willing to admit it, Ayden-Grifton has been more to us than a school for the last 4 years. It's been a home. Now it's time for us to spread out and find a new one. Even though our high school career is ending, the rest of our life is beginning. I wish everyone here good luck in all of their future endeavors, and I'd like to thank the parents, teachers, and other AG faculty members who have helped us all get this far. Once again, congratulations and good luck.
On behalf of the graduating class before me, I would like to thank the parents and loved ones that made this graduation possible. I found it incredibly appropriate I was given the opportunity to give this particular address, as it is a fact that I would not be standing on this stage today if it was not for the endless support I got from my parents and my grandparents. Many, if not all parents in this room, have served as our default tutors, cheerleaders, allies, confidants, and mentors for years. Without that assistance, I don't see how even half of us would be receiving our diplomas this evening. Parents, I would like to thank you once more and dedicate this graduation to you in honor of all you have done and all you have given. Thank you.
Good afternoon, and again, we'd like to welcome you to the graduation ceremony for the Ayden-Grifton High School class of 2012. This is a very special time for these young men and women, and they deserve a graduation exercise that is carried out with pride and dignity. On behalf of the class of 2012, I respectfully request that you remain seated during the ceremony, and please respect all students when diplomas are being awarded. I wish to acknowledge the faculty and staff members who are present today and to say thank you for the many assignments that were completed in order for this to be a successful commencement program. A special thanks goes to Marty Baker, our principal, and the graduation director, Mrs. Dawn Everett. We are pleased to have as our guest today the members of the Pitt County Board of Education. Mr. Billy Peden, Board Chair, Ms. Jill Kamnitz, Mr. Worth Forbes, Mr. Benji Forrest, Mr. Sean Kenny, Ms. Jennifer Little, Ms. Barbara Owens, Ms. Mary Williams, and the Superintendent of Pitt County Schools, Dr. Beverly Emery. At the conclusion of today's graduation ceremony, we respectfully request that all guests remain in the upper level until all seniors have exited the Coliseum. At this time, Marty Baker, our principal, will introduce the salutatorian and valedictorian of this year's class.
Because of the academic competitiveness of our top seniors, it has been very difficult to determine who the salutatorian and valedictorian would be for this ceremony. Folks, only 2/100ths of a point separate the top 2 to 3 students. That's amazing. Please give them a hand. During her 4 years in high school, Olivia Bjerkeset has been a leader in academics. She is highly motivated and a scholar. She is a member of the Superintendent Student Advisory Council, as well as the National Honor Society. She has served as the president of Mu Alpha Theta Math Honor Society and the Political Awareness Club. She was a junior marshal last year in 2011. We wish her well next year as she pursues a double major in psychology and criminal justice at the University of North Carolina at Greensboro. At this time, I would ask her parents, Blake and Teresa Bjerkeset, to please stand and be recognized. Thank you. At this time, it's my pleasure. Please join me and give a warm welcome to our salutatorian of the class of 2012, Olivia Bjerkeset.
I'm a big fan of 80s teen movies. Therefore, I thought I would become Molly Ringwald in high school. As you can see, that never happened. I didn't work at a New Wave record store. My grandparents never came to family events with an unexpected foreign exchange student, and I never got detention for skipping school to go shopping. In fact, I had perfect attendance this year. Even though John Hughes never stepped in to direct my life, and I never became the lanky redhead in the spotlight, I enjoyed high school. There are some things I'll never forget, starting with freshman year. Our freshman year, we all had to adjust to uniforms, which took some time. We had the simplest exam review we've had in all of high school, and we had one of the most entertaining pep rallies. I'll never forget Zach Pipkin dancing on the football field in a cheerleading skirt during the Powder Puff football game. Sophomore year was challenging. I thought honors chemistry would be the end of me. Taking theater classes in the band room instead of the theater room took some adjustment, and honors civics and economics was one of the most interesting classes I think I've ever taken. Junior year was very eventful. That was the year most of us started taking AP classes, and quite a few of us even took foreign languages online. The royal wedding also took place, so naturally, Shelby Lewis, Sarah Rabin, and I made tiaras and then took them around school taking pictures with every faculty member we could find. Mr. Skinner even found out about my Kennedy obsession and started to call me Jackie. Senior year was full of experiences and opportunities. All year long, I went to Ayden-Grifton High School in the morning and D.H. Conley High School in the afternoon. Going to two schools to take AP classes was bizarre and difficult, but it was also one of the best experiences I've ever had. To everyone who was able to make that possible for me, thank you. Now, as everyone prepares to go their separate ways, I'd like to leave you with a few final pieces of advice. President John F. Kennedy, do not pray for easy lives. Pray to be stronger men. Attorney General Bobby Kennedy, only those who dare to fail greatly can ever achieve greatly. French poet Anatole France, to accomplish great things, we must not only act, but also dream. Not only plan, but also believe. And the one thing that my parents have raised me to wholeheartedly believe, as Dr. Seuss once said, do what you want and say how you feel, because those who mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind. As each of you start your transition into adulthood, always remember to stay true to yourself. You can do whatever you want in life, as long as it makes you happy. You have a lifetime to look forward to. You might as well enjoy it. Thank you, class of 2012. It's been a pleasure.
Jenna Schortzma is a young woman of whom any parent would be proud. She is committed to excellence in every endeavor and strives to meet whatever challenge is placed before her. Academics have always been her top priority, as evidenced by her being a junior marshal in 2011 and a National Merit Scholarship finalist. She is a member of the National Honor Society and the Mu Alpha Theta Math Honor Society. Jenna will be attending Elon University and majoring in engineering. Jenna is the daughter of Kate Schortzma and the late Doug Schortzma. I would like to ask at this time for Mrs. Schortzma to please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Please join me as we welcome our valedictorian of the class of 2012, Jenna Schortzma.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of all the graduates, I would like to say thank you to our audience of parents, relatives, friends, board members, and faculty members for being here today. When I was looking for inspiration in writing my speech, I found this quote by William Arthur Ward. If you can imagine it, you can achieve it. If you can dream it, you can become it. It reminded me of all that we have achieved to reach this day and all that we can and will achieve in the future. Throughout the years, there have been many hardships which we endured, both as individuals and as a group. We have lived through many hurricanes, a great flood, tornadoes, fights, and national and global conflicts. We banded together during the bad times and persevered together. Our class has gained a great deal during our time together. We have gained in knowledge, in character, in common sense, and in an appreciation for what we've been given. We have earned the right to be here today and to be proud of our accomplishments. One of my favorite quotes is by Nelson Mandela. Mandela said that education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. He's right. What we have achieved over the past several years is the gathering of a knowledge base that gives us the power to go out and do something with our lives. Eleanor Roosevelt once said that the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Well, we are the future. We have the ability to dream big and achieve our goals. Our hour has struck. It is our time to shine, whether we plan to spend the next few years in college, in the workplace, or in the military. We have a base to jump off of, and we need only imagination, hard work, and a little luck to achieve anything we want. One of the most important things that I have learned in my 18 years is to take the advice of those who are older, wiser, and more experienced. Sometimes this is difficult, but it will aid us greatly on our road to success. I would like to pass on some of the advice that has been given to me. First, class of 2012, do something with your lives. Invent the next big thing. Create beauty to enliven our world. Provide entertainment to lessen boredom or pain and suffering. Save lives or improve someone's standard of living. Help the disadvantaged. Save the planet, its resources, or just one species. Prepare children to be the leaders of tomorrow. We can achieve any of this if we set our mind to it. Second, do what makes you happy. We are all more successful when we are doing things that we enjoy. Don't just have a job that you trudge through every day. Don't work just to climb the ladder in your career path. Find your calling. Find the job that you can look forward to each day. Third, don't be afraid to make mistakes. We all mess up sometimes. But it's important to remember that our mistakes are rarely as noticeable or memorable to others as they are to us. When I was scared to talk in front of people, my dad used to tell me that I wasn't the center of the world and that people generally had far more important things to worry about than whether I was doing something exactly right. To put it another way, people don't have a script of your thoughts and plans. They can't tell if you make a little mistake along the way. And for big missteps, it's best to just admit your error and attempt to fix it. Then it's not hanging over you. Next, I want to say thank you to everyone who has helped us on our path leading to this day. Thank you to the teachers who guided us through our years of schooling. It takes a special person to put up with so many kids or teenagers in one room. I found a quote by Albert Einstein that says it all. It is the supreme art of the teacher to awaken joy in creative expression and knowledge. So thank you, teachers, for all your hard work and patience. Thank you to all the other faculty members who provide the support system that keeps the school running. Your work allows teachers to do their jobs and students to have the environment they need in which to learn. A huge thank you has to go to parents and other family members who have provided support and encouragement throughout our lives. Thank you for always being there for us. I also want to take a moment to acknowledge relatives who could not be here today for whatever reason. I know I have deceased relatives who have continued to watch over me after they were gone. No doubt many of us have been touched in some way by those who have gone before us. I want to thank my friends and classmates for being there for me throughout the years. They have provided support and laughter when I needed it most. I feel that our class has become one big family over our time together. We've competed with one another, we've laughed together, cried together. We know one another's quirks, pet peeves, and best characteristics. In closing, I have to say, congratulations, class of 2012. We made it here to Minji's Coliseum to graduation day, despite the bumps, roadblocks, and pitfalls that stood in our way. We can look back and be proud of what we have achieved. Now we just need to follow the direction of this quote by Henry David Thoreau and go confidently in the direction of your dreams. Live the life you have imagined. Last of all, I want to wish you good luck in all your endeavors. You can do anything you set your mind to.
The Ayden-Grifton High School faculty and administration will honor our top four seniors today with a special gift. Seniors, when I call your name, please come forward. Will the parents of these top seniors please stand as your student, as your son or daughter receives the special award? Ranking number four, class of 2012, Jared Charles Engel. Number three, Sarah Catherine Raven. Salutatorian, Olivia Bjerkeset. Congratulations. And ranking number one, valedictorian, Jenna Nicole Schwartzma. Before we begin awarding the diplomas, I would like to honor our parents and want to say a special thank you as the principal of the school for all of your hard work over the last 18 years or so. You have done well. At this time, if you are a parent or you have helped raise these students, please stand at this time and be recognized. Please stand. Congratulations on a job well done. Our teachers and staff make up a family of committed educators who go the extra mile for our students. Often our teachers do not settle for anything less than the best each student can give. You'll find our teachers tutoring during their lunch period. You'll find them tutoring before and after school. And they're committed to modeling the characteristics that a charger should possess. Without the guidance and wisdom of our family of teachers and staff, this day would not be possible. Please give a round of applause for the Ayden-Grifton High School faculty. I would also like to recognize our recent staff retirees. Mrs. Rosa Cogdale, one of our custodians, who has 16 years of service. Please give her a hand. Mrs. Doris Grubbs, our career development coordinator, who has 30 years of service. And Dr. Linda Mattox, who retired in February, who has 30 plus years of service. Congratulations. We thank you for your commitment and dedication to the students of Ayden-Grifton High School, and we appreciate your years of service. Before we award the class of 2012 their diplomas, I would like you to please note in your commencement program those students who received special recognition as being in the top 10% of their class and as being recognized as North Carolina scholars. Congratulations to those students for your hard work. Please give them a round of applause. Class of 2012, I would like to publicly thank you. We've had an outstanding year, and ladies and gentlemen, before you, we have an outstanding group of young men and women. This class has worked hard and has been awarded scholarship money in the dollar amount of $1.35 million. Seniors, it's been a pleasure getting to know each of you, and I want each of you to know how much the administration and staff appreciates your support of Ayden-Grifton High School. You will always be a special group in our hearts. And now it's time for you to enter a new phase in your life. And again, we have enjoyed having you at Ayden-Grifton, and remember, you're always a charger. At this time, we will award the members of the class of 2012 their diplomas. This presentation represents 13 years, including kindergarten, of hard work and dedication of the 2012 Ayden-Grifton High School graduating class. Ladies and gentlemen, in an effort to ensure that each senior is recognized, please hold your applause until all diplomas have been awarded. Presenting the graduates their diplomas today will be Dr. Beverly Emery, Superintendent of Pitt County Schools. She will be assisted by Mrs. Dawn Everett and Mrs. Annette Glass. If they would come forward at this time. Well, the class of 2012, prepare to come forward as directed by our junior marshals. Will marshals and faculty please move to your positions at this time? Will the first row please stand? Edward Lance Abbott. Haley Jordan Allen. Samuel Sebastian Alvarado. Angel Lee Avery. Tania Connie Baker. Morgan Elizabeth Bell. Travis David Benson. Matthew Chase Bergs. Shinquetta Nicole Best. Olivia Bjerkeset. Stephen A. Bozeman. Christopher Thomas Braxton. Hazel Elizabeth Bright. Karima Lachelle Brock. Ashton Lang Brown. Dontario Lamarcus Brown. Maurice Dion Brown. Rochelle Jernay Bryant. Taylor Ann Cabanis. Kinsey Lee Campbell. Marquellus R. Cannon. Aries Shatoya Shakina Carmen. Demetrio Mikhail Carmen. Denisha Laquista Carmen. Virginia Marie Carmen. Daquan Lamont Carney. Keontae Timon Carroll. Maria Castro. Allison Marie Caton. Jonathan Rico Chapman. Caitlin Joanna Cox. Cody Hunter Crawford. Carter Jacob Kraft. Sadie Ann Crockett. Elizabeth Morgan Dale. Khadidra Ladon Davis. Douglas Everett Deans. Shaheem Dejan Dixon. Hunter Lee Donald. Deshaun Simone Dorsey. Justice Lakey Edmonds. Gwynetta Chavez Edwards. Hayden Robert Douglas Edwards. Marshall Wooten Edwards. Crystal Greg Ellis. Khadijah Shanquelle Ellison. Cheyenne W. Evans. Curtis Allen Everett. Trayvon Tyree Fleary. Simone Alicia Fornes. Gregory Shane Futrell. Diana Isabel Garcia. Ashley Nicole Gardner. Brandon Cannon Garris. Brittany Lee Gautier. Chelsea Chicole Gay. Marquise Jaquez Gay. Hasib Marcus Gent. Kareem Shelton Gent. Andrea Granados Trejo. Brandon Scott Gray. Najee W. Gray. Laquan Demetrius Green. Caitlin Denise Haddock. James Herbert Halliday. Haley Blair Hardy. Javen Wesley Sherrod Hardy. Shantavius Delise Harris. Antoinette Louise Harrison. Catherine Michelle Hart. Marquise Cornelius Heath. Anthony Dale Hernandez. Delilah Hernandez. Christopher James Hoffman Jr. Erica Nicole Hooker. Richard Kyle Huggins. Michelle Portia Hughes. Starvon Latrell Hunter. Jared Charles Engel. Derek Quinton Jackson. Geneva Rochelle James. Kevin Kanan Jeremy Jamal Johnson. Adriel Marquis Jones. Timothy Terrell Jones. Charles William Jordan II. Leah Chantel Kent. Holly Naya Kerr. Evan Gabriel King. Natalie Virginia King. Nicholas Austin Langley. Shelby Alexandra Hamilton Lewis. Elizabeth Danielle Lilly. Benjamin Parker Little. Charmaine Antoinette Little. Ruby Lopez. Justin Tyler Marrero. Luis Mendoza Martinez. Catherine Ann McCray. Avery Garrett McLawhorn. Frederick Dennis McLawhorn Jr. Sandy Giselle Medina. Devron Exxon Mewburn. George Ryan Mewburn. Jervon Marquell Mitchell. Latwayne Jasper Mitchell. Tyler Grady Mondovich. Megan L. Montero. Brianna Monique Moore. Ishmael Eli Moore. Mackenzie Taylor Moore. Trishelle Sharniquia Moore. Logan Nicole Mosley. Maurice Stephen Murphy. Christopher Paul Nichols. Jason Keith Nipple. Martrell Sharon Norfleet. Addie Trelawney Kiera Parks. Uriel Perez. Brianna Torrey Perry Cooper. Kiyosha Monique Peterson. Jaleesa Nicole Preston. Sarah Catherine Rabin. Jonathan Michael Riggs. Devin Patrick Roach. Shaniqua Nicole Robertson. Holly Elizabeth Roberts. Laquan Allen Rogers. Kiara Vache Rosenborough. Leslie Ann Marie Rouse. Christopher Britton Searcy. Justice Nicole Shannon. Jenna Nicole Schortzma. Bridget Dawn Smith. Justin Daniel Smith. Elizabeth Ann Spear. Matthew Todd Sugg. Khadidra Kenyelle Thompson. Ajalette Sehar Takante. Amanda Lee Tomlin. Urban Wendell Turnage II. Dylan James Vaughn. Walter Tyshawn Wallace. Lindsay Nicole Waters. Ebony Jasmine Webb. Brandon Lamar Whitaker. Shannon Danielle Whitaker. Kaylin Thomas White. Tiboria S. Whitehurst. Chelsea Dawn Willie. Defonte Cantrell Williams. Ariel Elizabeth Wilson. Kenitra Michelle Wilson. Tatiana Alexis Simone Wilson. Adam Davis Wingate. Selena Julianne Yanez. Joshua Richard Yasnitsky. Thank you. Class of 2012, please rise. Class of 2012, it gives me great pleasure to say to you, by the power vested in me by the state of North Carolina and the Pitt County Board of Education, based on the diplomas you have just received, I hereby officially declare you graduates of Ayden-Grifton High School. Congratulations, Class of 2012. At this time, Jonathan Michael Riggs will conduct the tassel ceremony and make closing remarks.
Will the class of 2012 please join me, being thankful to Almighty God, in the turning of our tassels. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2012. I'm privileged today to have the task of addressing the class of 2012 on this grand occasion, the last time we will all be together. In pondering the events of today, I must say that there is no place that I would rather be than right here. I'm extremely proud to be a part of this class, the 40th graduating class from Ayden-Grifton High School. We, the members of the class of 2012, have been through a lot together, and in our short 18 years on God's earth, we have seen a lot of history made. In 2009, we witnessed Hurricane Floyd firsthand. In 2000, we lived through the Y2K problem. We remember 9/11, the War on Terror, Hurricane Katrina, several different presidential elections, swine flu, bird flu, Hurricane Irene, and we will never forget the great Ayden-Grifton tuberculosis scare of 2012. The class of 2012 has also been very lucky to receive an education in the unique Ayden-Grifton way. I'll always be confident that Ayden-Grifton is the only school where you can learn economics by listening to songs like Can't Get No Satisfaction and She Got the Gold Mine, I Got the Shaft. Of course, we're the only ones lucky enough to have Coach Ross singing them for us. I challenge my classmates to never forget times like that that we spent together and to never take for granted the friendships that were formed through them. I also challenge my classmates to never take for granted one of the greatest freedoms we have in America, the freedom to a good education. We are truly blessed to live in the United States of America, where people are willing to die to guarantee us such freedoms. I would like to leave you all with a short phrase describing our class and also serving as a word of encouragement. Per aspera ad astra, which is Latin for through difficulties to the stars. Our class has been through many difficulties, and in reference to the way that we have overcome them together, I say to my classmates, not bad, not bad at all. Thank you all for coming today. God bless the class of 2012, and God bless the United States of America.